Hi, Namaste and a very warm welcome to Skin Doctor channel. I'm Dr.Sujith, Kumar, your dermatologist. A few days back, Rasha, a mother of a 5-year-old child, called me and requested me for an online consultation. Her daughter had fever and a reddish rash on the face and palms and soles. And during the online consultation, I came to the conclusion that the child has hand, foot, mouth disease and advised Rasha on how to manage the child and the illness. After a few days, the child completely recovered from her illness and Rasha called me to thank me. Rasha had written an article on hand, foot, mouth disease and posted it on an Instagram. She had sent me the article and I requested Rasha to write a detailed article on hand, foot, mouth disease. Rasha Rafi is an influencer and a marketing head at a very prestigious marketing company. Rasha is very good at writing and writes blogs. She's a blogger and she writes blogs for mothers on parenting and child psychology. Rasha has written an excellent article on hand, foot, mouth disease and we have posted it on our website www.skindoctorchannel.in. You can read Rasha's article on our website and encourage her. A few days from here, Rasha calls me again. This time she was really worried and tensed. She had noticed her daughter's nails shedding off and wanted to know what was happening. I consoled Rasha and told her not to worry at all. What she was seeing is a phenomenon called as onychomadesis, which is very common after hand, foot, mouth disease and several other viral infections, for example, chickenpox. Onychomadesis is a condition where the nails separate from the nail bed at the proximal end of the nail. When you say proximal end, our nail has got two ends. One is the outer end and the inner end. The outer end is called as a distal end and the inner end is called as a proximal end. So here in onychomadesis, the nail separates from the nail bed from the proximal end. The part of the nail at the proximal end below the skin is called as a nail matrix from which the nail is born. Onychomadesis happens because of a mild damage to the nail matrix because of the viral infections. Onychomadesis or nail shedding can happen after hand, foot, mouth disease or any other viral infection, especially chickenpox. It can also happen after many other severe illnesses and also due to some drugs. Onychomadesis has been reported even after taking very commonly used antibiotic like azithromycin and some other drugs. So if your child has onychomadesis, don't worry. Just look back in the past. Just see if the child has had any illness, any fever, and that could be the reason for the onychomadesis. If you're sure that the child had no illness in the past, then please consult your dermatologist and just try to find out what could be the reason for the onychomadesis. If your child has got onychomadesis due to hand, foot, mouth disease, please don't worry. All the nails will grow back within a period of 5 to 6 months because the rate of the nail growth is around 3 to 4 millimeter per day. Hand, foot, mouth disease is a viral infection caused by a virus called as Coxsackie virus, which belongs to the group of viruses called as enteroviruses. There are different variants of this virus called Coxsackie virus. It could be A16 or A6, which usually causes a common hand, foot, mouth disease. And depending upon the variant, the illness may be severe or mild. Usually, a hand, foot, mouth disease is a very mild illness, which lasts for a few days and just goes away. It doesn't need any active treatment, but just general care. Hand, foot, mouth disease usually presents with fever or a mild rash, sometimes without fever. The rash is usually small reddish lesions which appear around the mouth, on the palms and on the soles and sometimes inside the mouth. Very rarely does a hand, foot, mouth disease cause complications. Keep nursing the child properly and just watch for complications. And if you feel that the child is having very high fever and very severe illness, if you feel that the fever is increasing or that the rashes are increasing and the child's illness is becoming more severe, then please consult a pediatrician or a dermatologist and get your child treated. With this, we come to the end of this talk. If you like this video, please give a thumbs up and please don't forget to subscribe the channel. Until I see you next time with a new topic, take care. Bye.